Right now, we are going to see if this MacBook Air is any good or not. Super, super, super fast! But this ain't it, so let's go get it. Okay, so now we're back to see if this MacBook Air is any good or not. So this guy right here is the MacBook Air 15-inch that features the M2 silicon by Apple, and of course in, well, Apple fashion, they are going to compare all the specs with the previous generation of this laptop right here and basically tell you that this guy right here is 1.4 times faster than the M1 MacBook Air and around 12 times faster with, in comparison to any MacBook that features any Intel-based silicon. And that crazy runtime with the battery and the overall performance of the laptop definitely comes down to the M2 silicon, which features 8 CPU cores and 10 GPU cores, and of course a neural engine tying everything together to give you all that extra oomph in performance and of course that extra efficiency in running the machine. So what is very nice about this machine, first of all, it's of course its size. This is what appeals most users who are thinking to go into laptops from Apple or maybe upgrading from an older machine that you have from them. And this 15-inch, I think it's gonna strike the deal right in the middle, because previously you only had a chance of going to the 16-inch MacBook Pro, which is definitely more expensive than this, or maybe the 13-inch MacBook Air. So this strikes the coin in the middle with a 15-inch version of it, and that's really nice. And it also comes with a few features, one of them of course being the battery size. You have an increased battery size for this 15-inch laptop right here because you have an increased capacity in the overall space. A bigger chassis equals more space, that equals fitting more batteries in it. The only downside is that of course you are going to get a bigger screen, and I'm calling this a downside in air quotes because it's definitely nice to have a bigger screen, but of course that extra battery is going to be used up by that extra screen, so definitely you're not going to get an increase in runtime of this machine. They're kind of canceling each other out if you want, but Apple gives you around 18 hours of light browsing, or I should say light web browsing, but after my own testing I was only able to get 15 and a half of real time usage with this laptop right here, just doing continuous video loops from YouTube and actually using the screen with half the brightness and the volume as well with half the volume. So included with this 66 watts hour battery size in this laptop right here, you actually, amazingly, believe it or not, get a charger with it. You don't have to pay extra money for the standard charger. That is a 35 watts brick that features two ports that you can use to basically charge this laptop and any other devices that you have running out there. But it would have definitely been nice if Apple decided to give you the fast charge 70 watts brick. Of course, it featured only one port, but hey, you know, you could definitely charge off other devices using the laptop itself while doing, you know, charging, or I should say fast charging of the laptop from that brick. But hey, at least you get something. So you get the 35 watt charger by standard, and if you wanted to go out and spend more money, you could definitely choose that extra option with the 70 watts fast charger. Another nice thing about this laptop, which I definitely like, is definitely the braided cable that you get with it. It is actually high quality. It feels high quality and premium, and it should definitely feel so for the amount of money that you are going to pay. This is the MagSafe 3 version of it, and it's definitely doing a nice, it's doing its job very nice. I'm really, really happy that Apple listened to people out there and actually brought back MagSafe, because it's a very nice style of charger that leaves no room on the table for any sort of errors or problems, or, you know, yanking that cable off so you can yank the whole laptop off the desk and break it. So that's very nice to see that they've actually implemented this, and the cable that it comes with, it's very nice, it's braided, it's highly resistant, and I do think that you are going to have a long time use out of it before you have to change it out. The screen, oh my god, the screen. This is a liquid retina display, or what Apple calls it, because what you actually get with it is a 2880 by 1864 resolution. It looks absolutely amazing, sharp and crisp. It is good for video editing, good for videos, good for photo editing, and of course, web browsing. And the max brightness of it, it's actually 500 nits, or at least that's what Apple says. After my own testing, I was able to determine that it only goes up to 480 nits, but definitely that is more than enough in order to enjoy this laptop outdoors as well, because this being a MacBook Air, of course you would take this outside. The whole idea is that it is actually light and you can travel around with it everywhere and definitely use it in any sort of lighting conditions. Of course, the image looks very nice and crisp because this is an IPS panel, and although it's only rated at 60 hertz, it still looks absolutely wonderful when playing 4K videos on it, or even when gaming. Screen capacity wise, you could definitely extend this screen to another separate monitor that you can connect to the laptop using the Thunderbolt 4 display port out there, and you could go up to 6K 60Hz because that's the signal that you can basically get out of the Thunderbolt 4 for another monitor if you want to use it in some sort of setup. Another nice thing with this display right here is that of course you're getting a web camera that's a 1080p web camera. You don't have any sort of advanced features like let's say Face ID, because definitely if you are looking into that, then you are in the wrong place. You should be shopping around for a MacBook Pro, but you do have that in there. So if you want to use FaceTime, it manages to look quite okay even with the 1080p camera. The audio on this laptop sounds absolutely amazing. It features 6 speakers throughout the laptop that are actually hidden. There are no sort of grills or openings that the sound can travel out from, but it manages to do a very, very nice job. The sounds being quite crisp, quite bassy as well, and they're even rated for Dolby Atmos. So if you are having content that you want to play out of this laptop that features Dolby Atmos, then definitely you are going to take advantage of these speakers because they are quite loud, sound very, very nice, and yeah, they should give you some spatial awareness due to the Dolby Atmos feature.
It works! It's alive! It's alive!
Hello guys, and welcome in today's episode. I'm Alex, and today I'm overly excited to present to you one option that you have on the table if your budget is of around $1,000 for a brand new PC that you are looking to build by yourself. On the outside of this machine, we are greeted with a large trackpad, and that makes a lot of sense when dealing with a bigger chassis, and it is an absolute pleasure to use, as you would expect. The keys are the by now emblematic Pro travel keys, yet comfortable to use keys from Apple that features built-in backlight, and of course that can be adjusted, and a combo with a power Touch ID button. All of this comes neatly packaged in a 100% recycled aluminum body with curved edges that weigh 3.3 pounds and it is only 11.5 millimeters thick. But don't let the thickness fool you, as this is very sturdy and it has absolutely minimal flex to it. There's minimal flex to the keyboard, minimal flex to the screen, and minimal flex to the overall chassis. So yeah, this is a very nice and premium machine to touch and work with every day. So of course, this is nothing less than we'd expect from Apple. Connectivity wise with this machine, you actually get 2 Thunderbolt 4 ports, you get a headphone jack, and of course the charging port for this machine, and that's pretty much it. Although this machine might leave you stranded a little bit and can feel like a dongle jungle at times, don't worry, its ports are quite impressive, being able to both charge other devices and transfer data at an impressive rate that equals USB 3.1 and USB 4, and that means 10 gigabits per second and respectively 40 gigabits per second. Talking about all this high speed transfer rates, of course we have to talk about its Wi-Fi 6 capabilities and its Bluetooth 5.3. And not only that, of course, in order to handle all of this, the basic RAM configuration of this laptop right here comes with 8 GB of unified memory that you can definitely configure with 16 or 24 gigs. And there is also the options where you have to, well, basically can change the SSD in there. It comes with a standard 256 SSD, but you can definitely go as high as 512, 1 TB or 2 TB drive. But in order to have that, you will have to have very deep pockets. So with all this high talk out of the way, I think that we have everything technical wise mostly covered with this laptop right here. And even though we could be sitting here all day running some synthetic benchmarks at it and complaining about its scores, I am more about the real world stuff. Yeah, running games on a MacBook? Am I freaking crazy? Yeah, I know. Join me. Let's see. Because I'm pretty sure that you might be one of the guys who not only enjoys a nice laptop for web browsing, but come on, these laptops can do more than just web browse, right? I mean, you are paying for an M2 silicon in there. I'm pretty sure you're expecting highly of it, especially for the money that you are going to pay. I hope you know what this means, right? Bro, what do you mean you want to play on a Mac? Of course I'm gonna play on this Mac, and you know what? I'm not even gonna use macOS for that. Man, you know what? I think that installing Windows on this macOS right here is gonna be a tremendous pain, and not only that, but probably at the end of all things said and done, you are going to end up with a crappy version of Windows that's not even gonna work right at the end. Nonsense! I'm gonna install Windows on this machine and it's gonna take me just a few minutes and only a few clicks. And all of this with a very nice piece of software that is called Parallels. And as the name implies, of course, you are going to be able to run both Windows and Mac OS at the same time and do so with great ease and flexibility because you are going to be able to do file swaps between the two systems. You are going to be running, of course, all the native Windows apps without any sort of problem. And well, of course, even if you want to, you can do gaming. The installer is one of the benefits of the software once again because it's both easy and flexible to use. It allows you to actually download Windows from the official Windows Store if you don't own any previous versions that you might have bought. And not only that, but actually within a few clicks and a few minutes, you could be running up Windows without any sort of headaches or problems. I actually paid this piece of software for the past 1 year and was using it very nicely before they contacted me for this segue right here. And honestly, I can tell you that it is an absolute must for people that have applications that don't run natively on macOS. For instance, I'm running VCDS, that is a diagnostic scanning tool for the Volkswagen Audi group, and it only runs on Windows. So that's why I was using Parallel on my previous Mac, and it actually runs wonderfully. If you want to have a discount on this product and you want to check it out, the links are going to be down in the video description, and you can add at your checkout TechFusion10, that is TechFusion10, that is a coupon code that you can use for an extra 10% discount on their website. And of course, if you want to use it free for 30 days, you can do that. And if you are committed afterwards and you like the piece of software, don't forget to use TechFusion10, that is TechFusion10. You can find it in the links down in the video description right there. Add the coupon at the checkout and you have yourself a very nice experience. You know what, I'll bite, so sure, show me what you can do. So now I have configured everything using MSI Afterburner. I'm not really sure what to expect when running this in Windows with Parallels on basically a back process of macOS. But definitely we have Hogwarts Legacy lined up and we are ready to launch the game. Okay, so it seems that it does not want to work. So unfortunately, it seems that there is a problem with DirectX 12, so we have to revert back to previous older titles like the one we have here, which is Portal 2. I am using actually, as you can see, the Parallel Desktop 18 for Mac, and I am actually using the MSI Afterburner for this, so just that we can have on screen the FPS meter right here. There isn't very much that we can use the MSI Afterburner for, but yeah, we're gonna work with what we have. So, this being said, let's see how Portal 2 runs on this MacBook Air 15-inch Pro with a, Parallel installed on it. Right, so I see an issue with the game. First of all, the FPS meter there, it's all over the place. Anyway, more than 80, right? But you would expect that more than 80 FPS would actually feel rather smooth. Even though this is an IPS 60Hz panel, the whole experience is actually atrocious. We are running all the settings at as high as they can go, and I have the laptop plugged in, but the resolution is maybe a bit high. The advance, as you can see, everything is set to as high as it would go with this title right here, and the only, rather good thing that I could do is scale down the resolution in hopes that this title is gonna run a little bit smoother. And okay, right now it's really, really smooth. It is exactly what I would expect. The FPS meter, for some reason, now it's stuck at 60, so definitely we are doing more than 60 before, 80 or around 90 something ish FPS. But at least this time around we have a very smooth 60 FPS experience, so all I had to do is basically turn down the resolution with this title in order to get some decent performance out of it. So basically this is the standard resolution of the screen. I don't know why the resolution was set to higher than this, but definitely setting it to its native resolution helped a lot. So yeah, definitely you can run titles that are running the DirectX 11. Unfortunately with Parallels for the moment, DirectX 12 is not enabled. And because of that, basically you can't really play new titles emulating Windows in Mac OS. So as you can see, we're still running Mac OS right here. Everything is running fine. And of course, if we swipe to the right, then we are back in Windows and we are able to resume the game. So now I think it's high time that I give you a piece of my mind regarding this MacBook Air 15-inch M2 processor right here. This machine is actually very, very wonderful. The fact that you can run this machine for a few days without worrying about battery, it's absolutely genius. The more I think about this, the more I like it, because you can travel around places, don't have to worry about getting that battery charged if all you're doing is just light browsing the internet now and there. And not only that, but the fact that it doesn't have any fans, it's actually amazing as well. And I never actually noticed this laptop getting very hot. You would expect for something that is just passively cooled by its aluminum chassis to actually get very hot on your lap when using this laptop. And even though I was doing editing on this laptop, with the charger connected or the charger disconnected, I never felt this laptop right here getting very hot, which is actually a very nice thing to see with this laptop right here. All in all, this M2 processor seems to be quite a beast. It can handle both editing and both video playback, 4K video playback, and even some light games, as you have seen with Parallel running in Windows, because Parallels can only emulate DirectX 11. But definitely, if you want to do some light gaming on this machine, you can do it much better using Windows with Parallel than you would actually be able to do it with macOS. Overall, I would say that its flexibility in terms of battery, its usage, and of course its ease of use, and basically having that this is such a robust piece of kit, it's actually very, very nice to see with a laptop nowadays. It is, I think, the pinnacle of what MacBook Air should have been from the start. It was very, very good in the past as well, but this is definitely working and improving on the past achievements, and this is a very nice laptop to go with. Alright guys, thank you very much for choosing to watch another Tech Fusion videos. If you had liked this video, you know what to do. Maybe hit that subscribe button and see you guys in the next one. Otherwise, there should be some videos around, just popping around, that you can definitely check out, and see you guys in the next one. Peace!